It's a special day at the University of Tennessee as Kellie Harper, better known as Kellie Jolly during her playing days with the Lady Vols, has now returned as the head coach. Kellie, welcome back. It's great to have you.
Thank you. It is great to be back. Not many people had the opportunity to go back to their alma mater. This is something really special.
Kellie, I'm sure it's been a whirlwind in terms of the talking about taking this job and talking to Coach Fulmer. Talk about when he finally offered the job to you. Just what went through your mind and your body?
Well, it was surreal. I was off by myself, walking around outside, and just a lot went through my mind in that moment. And almost didn't answer him because I had all these thoughts in my head. And yes is the answer. Just so humbled, I think. To think of the position and the magnitude that this position is in women's basketball, is for this university, and just grateful for the opportunity and super excited about it. I just feel like it's something special that we can get excited about and be successful with.
Those teams you played on in the late 90s really helped build the tradition too, with those three straight national championships. How much did those teams affect you personally? And maybe your coaching philosophy, too, because they were so tight-knit, such talented teams, and they achieved so much.
Well, I think anytime you have an experience like winning national championship, it changes who you are, and it affects you. We won those three straight. If we had won the fourth, I probably wouldn't be able to walk in the studio. My head would be so big. So probably
close.
May not be a bad thing. You're right. We were super talented. And I think just looking back and the chemistry that we had and – the type of players and how we were, all just so driven to win a national championship. We were all on the same page. I just look back that often as a coach and think about how special that was, that just such a unique group and, great times.
Pat Summitt gives you a lot of credit for helping with the toughness of that team, because it takes toughness to win a championship. That's a great compliment, especially to a point guard, and she was awfully hard on her point guards.
If I can give someone a toughness compliment, it is one of the highest compliments you can get. So getting that from her, I don't take that lightly, obviously. But, I think everybody had their own role. I think everybody has to bring something, and my teammates were tough, too. I wasn't as athletic. I wasn't as big, strong, as talented as something. I had to bring something, so maybe the toughness and the ability to find the open man gave me some things to help that group with.
But in one year in the NCAA tournament, you'd sprained your ankle, and you actually spent a couple of nights in the training room to make sure you could play. That's toughness.
Well, you got to do what you got to do. If you love to play, you got to do what you got to do. And, I remember going in and getting evaluated, and I thought, if I limp on my other foot, then maybe they won't see it, and maybe they'll just say I could play. And when they told me, there was no reason I should have played, could have played, but I guess I faked it enough that they let me get back out there, because it was so important to me to be able to help my team. I knew I was needed, and you just want to, if you're a player, you just want to play.
Yeah, indeed, and you played a lot of great basketball at Tennessee. Now you've gone into coaching for 15 years as a head coach. You've been to the NCAA tournament 5 years. You went to the Sweet 16 this year with Missouri State on what was really a magical run, because you started the season 1-7.
Well, we were talented early on. We only had one senior. We had five freshmen, six sophomores. So we had a lot of growing to do early in the season. And I tell you, when we don't schedule lightly. When we schedule, we're going to schedule tough teams for who we are. And we were on the road, lost some close ones early, and just hadn't reached that maturity yet. And at some point, we saw how talented we were. It wasn't a surprise. The run wasn't a surprise to our staff, because we saw how talented we were. But we just had to get them there. We had to give them the confidence and the ability to play together to make it all come together.
And your team won 24 out of 26. That's quite a run.
It was a great run in the season, I think, beating three straight ranked opponents. Mm-hmm. It was really an impressive run, but the thing that I was most excited about was to watch our team come together and to watch them believe in the vision that we had for them, and to see them have that success. It was really special.
Most times when a coach leaves, there's some people that are a little bit upset. On the front page of the Missouri State website, they had a big thank you, Coach Harper, for what you've done for the program. That has to be very special for you.
Yeah, it is. They're great people there. And it's hard to say goodbye to great people, and it is hard to walk in there to a team that did everything you asked them to do and to tell them you're moving on. It's really difficult, and I was really close to those players, and
But they were happy for you.
They were happy for me. They're such good people. I went around the room and hugged, and one of them said, "I am so proud of you." And I lost it at that point. So, but, you know, that's when you have something special. You know, when you have good players, good people, and good character, and really pull for each other.
You've been at now this year fourth different school as a head coach. You've learned a lot of things over these last 15 years. Talk about some of the lessons, some of the hard lessons you've learned.
Well, you know, if you're wherever you go, you're gonna learn. You have to learn. You have to keep learning. And you know, when I first took the head coaching job, my first head coaching job, I was the youngest head coach in the country. And the first year was just a blur. Everything was new. And you know, you take it, a leave there and go to NC State, and it's just an unusual situation with, you know, taking over for a coach that had passed away in the middle of the season. It was just really difficult. And you know, so I've been through a lot. I really do think I've been through a lot that has helped prepare me, both good and bad, you know, because I've seen a lot of different situations, been able to handle a lot of different situations. And the one thing that I feel like I can be proud of is I always felt like our teams hung in there and our teams played hard and our teams always improved. And I think if you're gonna be a championship team, which we want to be here, obviously you've got to be peaking at the right time. So we got to get this team ready to rock and roll and learn how to cut down some nets.
There you go. You've had two coaches that really had big impacts on your life. Your dad, who you played for at White County, and then, of course, Pat Summitt. Talk about the influence those two coaches have had on you and what have they meant to you in your coaching career.
Yeah, well, I think anyone that asked me growing up or in life who was your hero, it was always my dad. And I think he did things similarly to Pat in that it was always classy. He was so humble and unselfish and just such a good person. Basketball-wise, he had a great basketball mind. He understood the game. But I think it was just more than that. He's just such a good person. And then, obviously, coming to play for Pat, if you don't take anything from that, you're not trying. And, you know, just to be around her was something special. Her presence and her knowledge and her personality, just she was everything.
She's still with you, isn't she?
Yes, she is. And it, you know, it's going to be – the next few weeks are going to be hard, I think, at times emotionally, because I'll be thinking about Pat and my dad who passed, and just some people I know would be really proud.
So you get the call from Coach Fulmer, and then you hit the ground running, don't you?
Absolutely. You know, you have a lot of priorities right now in recruiting your signees, your current players. There's just a very long to-do list, and we're excited about it.
Being through this before, though, I mean, you've had these transitions before. That's got to be a help right now for you?
Absolutely. You know, you realize how quick things are going to happen, and your time gets gone from you very, very quickly. And you really know where you need to spend your time. Your current players have to feel like they're getting you. You know, they're getting your time, and you have to give that to them, as well as the signees. And obviously recruiting is always a priority, so you've got to get in there with that as well.
How was the first meeting with the team today?
I thought the meeting went good. I thought it was good. And just go in with just be myself and let them kind of hear from me a little bit. I think just meeting the new head coach takes a little anxiety off of them. It's now, there's actually someone real now. They can see them and talk to them.
Takes the anxiety.
It does. I really think it does. I think that's important. And let them ask me a few questions. And, you know, they walked out of there. And I think body language is a big thing for me. So just kind of watching to see how they reacted. So I felt good about it.
A lot of times they say that coaches, especially had success as a player, that can make an impact too. When you tell them you won three national championships, I'm sure that kind of impresses them a little bit.
Well, I hope so, because that's very hard to do, and not many people have done that. But just, I think the thing is just to explain to them that I've been there. I've been in their shoes, and I know what it takes to be successful in their shoes here at this university that I have a lot of passion for.
Has it hit you yet? You're the head coach of the Lady Vols?
Not really. Not really. You know, I think for me right now, the biggest thing is just getting that list done and just getting right to work. And at some point, I'm going to sit at that desk probably by myself for about 30 minutes and just take it all in. But I'm just too busy to do that right now.
Well, we're very thrilled that you're here. Congratulations on getting the job. Look forward to watching your teams play, and they'll have that same toughness and determination you had. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Kellie Harper, the Lady Vol new head coach.